visionary is a vision.
There's been one question that Kate Tempest has never been able to escape.
Since I was a child, people used to stop me in the street and say, "What are you? What are you? What are you? A girl or a boy, what are you?" Like, since forever. Now I'm a grown-up adult and people are still like, "What are you? Are you a poet or a playwright?"
Yes and yes. And a rapper and a spoken word artist and a novelist. And tonight, perhaps a combination of all of them.
We are ferocious. We are open. Explosives have nothing compared to these sparks. So please, let's fall apart.
For the 34-year-old Londoner, versatility isn't the trick. It's all part of the creative trade.
Why would you put brackets around your creativity? Creativity is so boundless. Like, you might have your little habits that you get into, your conventions, you might have the things that you like, but expression is, it's limitless.
Tempest says this instinct was born from a childhood love of books and an obsession with hip-hop that compelled her to write and at 15 start rapping in public, at record stores, parties, anywhere she could find a mic.
There was nothing else in my mind. There was only that. So there was no like courageous like approach to the mic. It was just blind ambition, just I need.
But it was through poetry and spoken word that she would start to build her audience, something she at first rejected.
A really close friend of mine who taught me a lot about lyricism and rapping, he used to say to me, "You're a poet." And he used to say, like, "Have you ever read Emily Dickinson?" And I read her and I was like, "What's he trying to say about my lyrics?" Like, I was offended. I was like, "I want to be a rapper like you and you're telling me to read Emily Dickinson." And I just didn't get it. But now I understand what he was trying to say, that there was a different space that my lyricism was occupying and that I shouldn't be afraid of it.
In 2012, her poem, Brand New Ancients, won the UK Poetry Society's Ted Hughes Award for Innovation in Poetry. Tempest remains the youngest recipient of the award. The story of two intertwining London families was described by The Guardian as an everyday epic of small heroics and bad behavior.
It's all that we've always had. We have jealousy, tenderness, curses, and gifts. But the plight of a people who have forgotten their myths and imagine that somehow now is all that there is a sorry plight.
This was all happening right around the time her first play, Wasted, was touring throughout the UK. It wasn't until 2014 that Tempest released her first solo rap album, Everybody Down.
I'm in a mess, I can't help it. I just go round and round. I'm paranoid, I'm selfish.
She followed that with a best-selling novel, The Bricks That Built the Houses, a story built around the characters introduced in Everybody Down, Becky and Harry. Becky, a struggling dancer working as an erotic masseuse on the side, and Harry, a dreamer hoping to build something better while dealing cocaine.
Intentionally, there are these characters walking in and out of all my work. Like, there are things that I've been grappling with trying to say ever since I started to put pen to paper. I'm still trying to get this stuff out of me.
Everybody Down and her second album, 2016's Let Them Eat Chaos, were both shortlisted for a Mercury Award, the UK's annual recognition of the best album of the year. But it's with her most recent offering that Tempest's many styles may have started to overlap.
It's coming to pass. My country's coming apart. The whole thing's becoming such a bumbling farce. Was that a pivotal historical moment we just went stumbling past?
Working with legendary producer Rick Rubin and Tempest's musical partner Dan Carey, The Book of Traps and Lessons was described by NPR as gigantic, alive, and radical.
Give me your beautiful, crumbling heart.
The stripped-down album is brimming with tangled tales of love and loss, hope and despair, all fighting to find balance with one another. A battle that Tempest says has gotten easier for her as she's gotten older.
My head is ringing from the love of the stars.
It's got such a slow ramp up, you know. Intentionally, it's very intimate in its address, and it's a much more, it's stripped back, as we say. What I'm realizing is that it's about setting the lyric free from the convention of sticking with the beat. I mean, obviously, it's really fun to stay on the beat. Exciting, but like, You can overexcite yourself rhythmically and then you can forget to stay true to the integrity of the meaning.
Do you think of it still as a musical performance or is this something else?
Yeah. Yeah, I definitely think of it as musical performance. Even though it, like, what is it? I don't know. But like, I think of it as music, yeah. Because I know those lyrics wouldn't exist without their music. They wouldn't be poems. They would never have had life if I'd sat down to write them as poems.
Do you think you're changing hip hop?
It's not enough.
No. I think hip hop changed me, for sure. And I feel very, very grateful. If I can lay my offering at the altar of hip hop and say thank you so much for everything that you taught me and everything that you gave me in my life. And here's my contribution, which is hopefully something that is raw, true inspiration and love for the form. But coming from where I'm coming from, you know, and about the things that I've experienced.
And this age is our age, but our age is rage sinking to beige. And yes, our children are brave, but their mission is vague. Is your life well lived or is your life well displayed? I don't have the answers, but I believe there are still things to say. I stare out at my city on another difficult day and I scream inwardly, man, when will this change? I'm beginning to fade, but my sanity saved because I can see your faces. Because I can see your faces, it's hard. We got our heads down and our hackles up, our backs against the wall, man, I can feel your hearts racing. None of this was written in stone. The current's fast, but the river moves slow. And I can feel things changing. Even when I'm weak and I'm breaking, I stand weeping at the train station. Cause I can see your faces. There is so much peace to be found in people's faces. I love people's faces.